Just real quickly about the interior, you could just, I just rewritten something about this, I was asked to. About three elements on the inside, lighting, space, and symbolism. And the, it is, if you're an American doing a typical American museum, you assume that the space has to be flexible because the museum art elements are going to vary over time. In this case, this is a collection which is the greatest collection of Renaissance, Italian Renaissance paintings in the world outside of Italy. And so you're not going to change. It's going to be the same. You're not going to buy a new Raphael every 5 years. So we made it so that the assumption was that it will more or less be the same forever on that. The second was that the lighting has to be very carefully done because they wanted appropriately some natural light, but the natural light has to be very carefully controlled for the sake of the preservation of the paintings. So we have clere storeys at the top where we have very, very, very up-to-date, complex, sophisticated, technical elements that control the light as the light changes over time, the cloud goes by and things like that. And then we made the symbolism inside connect with the architecture of Sir John Soane's gallery called Dulwich. And that was one that we liked Dulwich, also the client liked Dulwich. And so we kind of made it in the historical style of Dulwich and not just plain modern, because plain modern didn't work for other reasons as well. And that, of course, irritated some people who were pure modernists.